Hey there, Jake with B&H. Today I traveled upstate to explore the beautiful and vast Hudson Valley. And I brought along with me a pretty cool new toy, the DJI Mavic Air. As I make my way up to the top of the mountain, I'm going to be testing out the brand new image quality, the refined flight controls, and some smart capture modes. Let's go for a hike. Come on. Okay, now to the naked eye, the Mavic Air is gonna look pretty similar to the Spark. In many ways, it is. I mean, this is designed for travel vloggers and outdoor enthusiasts. I mean, just look how small this thing is, right? I'm gonna zip this guy open. That's it. Foldable prop arms. Foldable prop arms. Ready to go. One, and a two, and a three, and a four. Bingo. And then bring these guys down. Bam. Teeny tiny. This is the first drone from DJI to have internal storage, up to 8 gigabytes. And there's a micro SD card slot as well. The battery life is about 21 minutes, which isn't bad given the size. I only had to bring 3 batteries with me today, as opposed to the Spark, I would have had to bring like 5 or 6. And 3-axis gimbal. Let's get this puppy in the air, come on. Oh man, the river's like half frozen. There's a train going by. It's very loud, blowing its horn. Right when I'm trying to talk to you. Now, probably the most significant addition to the performance of the drone has to be the obstacle avoidance sensors. DJI Mavic Air now has 6 cameras on it for positioning, which will drive the APASC feature. That stands for Advanced Pilot Assistance System. And this will automatically force the DJI Mavic Air to go up and over or around obstacles as opposed to just stopping right in front of them. So you didn't do that? Did that on its own?
I did it on its own. I was just moving forward.
Now with the video quality, that's where we see drastic improvements on this guy. It can now shoot Ultra HD 4K up to 30 frames per second at 100 megabits per second, which is a vast improvement over the Mavic Pro that was only 60 megabits per second. More information, more detail, better looking images. You can still take 12 megapixel stills, but there's an exciting new feature exclusively on the Mavic Air, and that's Panorama Mode. You press one button, the camera takes several pictures all at once, stitches them together within 8 seconds, and you have a panoramic photo. So if you look up there, way up there, that's where we just were. Problem is, too many trees, so we couldn't really test the ActiveTrack mode the way I wanted to, as well as the other preset modes, so we came down here to this beautiful wide open dock and park area right on the Hudson River itself, and we're gonna try the ActiveTrack modes and the Boomerang and the Asteroid, so let's get to it, guys. ActiveTrack. Yes, trace is okay. No, just this guy. I'm gonna hit record. It's following me as I walk. It's following me. Wow, as I trip. I'm okay. I'm okay, everybody. Nice. Ta-da, that worked. New frame rates have also been added. For the first time, you can now capture your high-speed adventures at 120 frames per second in full HD, making for some buttery smooth drone cinematography. Yep. There we go. Holy cow. Holy cow. The Mavic Air also offers two new preset flight modes. One is called Boomerang Mode, which kind of goes in and then out, and then in and then out. This is Boomerang. And coming back, just like a boomerang would. And the other one's called Asteroid Mode. I'm gonna be honest, I don't really know how to describe that one, so I think it's just best we go try it out. Come on. This is Asteroid. Oh boy, that is going way up there. So it's literally pulling back, taking video, and then simultaneously taking photos at the same time to combine the video and the series of photos into a spherical portrait, like a panorama sphere. I hope it works. It's doing its thing. So that was an asteroid. Pretty cool. Nailed on the first try, I think. Not gonna lie, really enjoyed my experience with the new DJI Mavic Air. Really super easy to use, footage looks awesome, and the 120 frames per second in active track mode is just too much fun. I'd say if you're a pro who's looking for a more portable drone without sacrificing image quality, yeah, I got the drone for you. I'm gonna go inside now because I can't feel my face. This is Jake with B&H. Just keep shooting.